In this study, we use a workflow for rapid pull-down of endogenously attacked PI3K subunits from mouse tissue to define the PI3K signaling network under conditions of physiological PI3K signaling, namely in healthy prostate, versus hyperactive PI3K signaling, namely in PTEN-null prostate. PTEN-null prostates have high levels of PI3K lipid products PIP3 and PI3K/4P2. We found that a 20-minute total time of pull-down achieves the ideal balance between maximum protein yield while maintaining protein-protein interactions and signaling complexes. We use TMT labeling to barcode individual genotypes, multiplex, and compare the relative amounts of interacting proteins between control, no heavy pull-downs, and PI3K heavy pull-downs. Intriguingly, we found that the PI3K signaling network is not simply hyperactivated in PTEN-null prostate, rather, it is rewired, as highlighted in the heat map here. We see major decreases, most notably in IRS family members, like IRS1. And we see major increases too, most notably in PLEKHS1. Taking a more detailed look and plotting the relative abundances of each interacting protein, we see decreases in EGF receptor, IRS family members IRS1, 2, and 4, known IRS4 interactor WDR6, and SHC1. Some interacting proteins are unaltered in PTEN-null prostate, and many are increased, with PLEKHS1 being exclusively found in PTEN-null prostate. Read further and we demonstrate that in healthy prostate, PI3K signaling is largely driven by RTK-IRS signaling and fine-tuned by negative pathway feedback. In the absence of PTEN, the PI3K signaling network is dramatically rewired and negative pathway feedback is intensified. PLEKHS1, previously a poorly studied protein, escapes pathway feedback. Rather, PLEKHS1 is subject to positive feedback from PI3K activity and becomes a major driver of PI3K signaling and tumor progression in a cell autonomous manner and independent of growth factor receptors. Importantly, PI3K signaling is rewired in broader contexts of hyperactive PI3K signaling. Finally, we present evidence that PI3K pathway rewiring is relevant in the clinic.